Wednesdays on Number 6 with Cheese are local food reviews. Today, no exception. We're headed to the Duck Inn. And also, Food Network named their dog top dog in the game in the United States. So we're gonna go slam some encased meats and figure out why the Duck Inn is so revered in the city of Chicago. Got the merch on, got the sun shining. Let's go. Two Duck Inn dogs from the Duck Inn. The OG acquired jump cut. I'm seeing spots, so I'm very hungry. Corey Wagner's second angle.
All right, open it up, and there we go.
Oh no, casualty.
Over.
Okay. Casualty.
Well,
let's see if the other one would be mine.
What do we got?
Oh geez, the presentation is not great.
No, it's big old thing with some stuff on it. Looks like bird vomit.
It does. It really, really does. Really thought it was going to be beautiful looking, to be honest with you. The photo of the dog on the website is immaculate. All right, it's not starting out great, but we'll see how good it is. The Duck Inn OG dog. Cheers.
Cheers. Oh, that's a pretty good taste.
So it's all natural beef, cooked in duck fat, in a pork casing, celery salt, jalapeno, pickle, tomato, mustard. This is like a Chicago style hot dog on steroids.
How much is this bad boy?
A lot. I ordered two pickup and it was $27.
Wow. I mean, it's huge.
Mm-hmm.
Like, you wouldn't need two of these.
No, by no means.
Flavor's good. It just tastes like kind of a bigger hot, like a good hot dog,
mm-hmm,
but a bigger version of it.
Yeah, the beef's really good. There's a sweetness there. I'm getting like more of a sweetness than even normal. Maybe that's through the pickle. I'll say this, I think like a Maxwell Street Polish from Fatso's or Portillo's is more my speed. Like, I love how thick this is and I like that it's meatier, because a lot of times with Chicago style hot dog, the hot dog is warm, the bun is like kind of room temperature, and then all the vegetables are cold. So it's just like weird like texture and like different temperatures going on. So like with the Maxwell Street Polish, it's all warm. I always like when the whole dog is all the same temperature. There's a lot going on with this. Like, the sweetness is very apparent in this. I think there's relish. I think that's relish.
Mm.
Relish is sweet, that's what it is.
Relish is sweet? I've never really had relish. So mm-hmm. I'm not super familiar with that flavor.
That's sweet.
Mmm. I like sweet stuff. Maybe I like relish.
You might.
I've never gotten it because I don't like the way it looks.
Yeah, it looks weird. Mm-hmm. But I think you'd like it.
Man, now that I know it's sweet, I'm gonna have to start getting that on stuff.
Mm-hmm. I think I do like Maxwell Street Polishes better than that too, though, because...
You like sausage better than hot dogs?
I like sausage, I like the grilled onions, I like the mustard just kind of by itself. I don't like a ton of stuff on a hot dog.
Grilled onions is a big, to like be missing. I mean, they had some grilled onions, but not the way the Maxwell Street does work. Because Maxwell Street does like the strings, right?
They're like shoestrings.
And it's covering it.
Yeah.
I like that way better than this is like the diced.
Yep.
They don't hit as hard when they're diced.
I know.
Those long string ones.
I agree.
You can taste them warm.
I know.
Yeah. Yeah, I might like the Maxwell Street. I don't know, it's tough to say. I'd have to eat them back to back, but.
I said in our 30K video, I think that should be the Chicago style hot dog.
Yeah, and I agree with you.
Yeah, I just like, I love those, man.
I kind of agreed with you. I gave a caveat that it should also have something else on there. I can't remember what I said. Jardinera, yeah.
Which would be fantastic.
Mm-hmm.
That's the Corey Polish. Well, regardless of that being turned upside down and punted around the kitchen, still turned out very tasty.
Yeah, dude, especially compared to Chicago-style hot dogs that I've had in the past.
Yeah. I've started to come around a little bit to the celery salt and tomato thing, but, like, I'm not quite there yet. I'm trying to get there.
I like that they minimized the tomatoes there.
It was very little tomato.
They had, like, and they were cut kind of like the onions where they're diced up rather than, like, a full tomato.
Well, yeah, Chicago-style hot dogs, they're literally in, like, quarters.
Like,
they're
laid.
Your whole bite is a piece of tomato.
I like that.
I don't think anybody needs that in their life. All right, before we go ahead and rate the Duck Inn OG dog, let's do a shout-out.
Podcast shout-out. That's right, ladies and gentlemen, we got a podcast. It is awesome.
The Unemployables Pod, it's a lot of fun. It's me, Sean, and it's our good friend, Zach O'Ryan. And lately, we've been going on Twitch and live streaming at 3 p.m. Eastern every single Monday. We get on there, so if you want to see us live, we do interact with our fans in the comment section a great deal. Kind of allow you guys to form our conversation, to shift our conversation, to guide our conversation. So it's a real back and forth that we have with our fans, and boy, do I love it. So check that out. That's at The Unemployables on Twitch. So I guess twitch.tv/unemployables probably.
It is. That's correct.
Awesome. So yeah, check out The Unemployables if you haven't already. Subscribe, like, blah, blah, blah. Do the things. Blee, blee, blee. Peace be with you.
Also with you. All right. Apologize for all my blabbering about things that clearly don't matter. let's go ahead and rate that out of 5. Darkwing Ducks. Remember him?
Yeah, a little bit. I'm sure Google remembers them.
Out of 5 Darkwing Ducks, how many Darkwing Ducks do you give the duck and OG dog, Corey Wagner?
That's pretty good. I mean, let me ask you a question on what you're going to compare it to. Do I compare it to all hot dogs, including like chili dogs? Do I compare that just to Chicago-style dogs?
I'm going to compare it to all hot dog entities.
Okay, cool. So that's still pretty good. I still like that, like... definitely a lot more than I like all the other Chicago style dogs.
Yeah.
I still think chili dogs are better. That's just my, I mean, meat on meat is my move.
Yeah.
But that's still really good. I'm gonna give that a 4.
Oh, that's a great score. Yeah, I mean, you have beef and you have the pork casing and you have duck in there and then all the spicy and sweet. That was a really good blend of stuff. As you probably know, I still think Maxwell Streets are like the pinnacle.
That's not a hot dog. Are you comparing
it to that? That's sausage. That's true. You're right. I have to compare this to other just hot dogs.
Because I definitely think that, I mean, I would like sausage because the spices and stuff are better.
Yeah, I like how thick that hot dog was. You normally, you don't get dogs that thick.
That's very
so
true.
That's like, that was really cool that was so big.
Yeah.
Man, do I love duck fat? I think maybe that's just also amazing.
Yeah.
Yeah, you know, I'm a Detroit style Coney guy, but that was damn good. I'm gonna go 4.0.
I think
that's a good score. Like, that was, you know, the reason I'm like at a loss for words a little bit at the end here is because that is really unique.
Mm-hmm.
Like, despite it took the Chicago thing and kind of turned it on its head. Like, the more I think about it, the more excited I am. They also have a ton of different dogs. I'd love to just like run through them all. You know, any and all dumbness that I've shown today, I was pretty much dying seeing spots before this episode. So I'm still coming to grips with what today is.
Yeah, with reality. Yeah, it was a lightheaded move for you today, man. Starving yourself, bro. I respect it.
It's cold and warm and room temperature. And it's like the same.
You're like, hold on, what are you talking
My
about?
Analytical brain just blew up. What the hell are you talking about?
Look, I wasn't the protagonist today, okay? we'll see you guys tomorrow for a brand new episode, Thursday fast food video. Thank you to all the supporters of the show, the merch flying off the shelves, probably.
We hope.
Yeah, you can only hope. We'll see you guys tomorrow. Have a great rest of the day. Stay safe. Kiss your loved ones from a distance.